Welcome to my channel, which is Mother's Flavor. I am Nikita. I am making today Shahi Jeera rice. The reason why I am making Shahi Jeera rice is because I really like the nutty, fresh flavor of Shahi Jeera over the normal jeera. If you have never tried the Shahi Jeera rice, I would definitely suggest you to try out the Shahi Jeera rice that I am going to be showing in this video. And if you really like what I am showing, do hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. To make Shahi Jeera rice, we will be needing a tablespoon of ghee and then one bay leaf and about some 8 to 7 of cloves, 1 inch of cinnamon. Here I'm using Shahi Jeera. You can also use the same with the normal jeera. And I'm using cashew here. This is optional. If you want, you can be using this, or else you can just leave it. And I'm using 1 cup of basmati rice here. And I have washed it thoroughly and soaked it in water. First, let's heat a pan. And now we'll just add some ghee to this. Once the ghee becomes hot, ensure to not heat your ghee a lot, because if you heat it a lot, then everything will just flutter up. Once it's on a medium heat, just add the bay leaf, the cinnamon, and now just add the cloves. And now we'll just let this be like this and let all the masalas infuse and release its oil, and all of that oil, let it just get infused inside the ghee. Now we'll just add in some cashews and we'll roast this till it turns golden brown. As you can see, now the cashew has changed its color. Now it's time to add in our Shahi Jeera. Now once our jeera starts spluttering, lower down the flame and add in water. Now here I have measured my rice with this cup, using this cup. So I'm gonna add 2 cups of water from this. Now it's time to add in some salt. Now we'll increase the flame to medium high, and now as you can see, there's slowly bubbles started coming in our water. Now we'll just add in our rice. Now as you can see, the rice is boiling. So now we'll just lower our flame and we'll just close it and let it cook. Now as you can see, all the water has got drained out. Now it'll just take another 5 minutes. Just close it and it'll be done. Now as you can see, the rice is really well done. Now we'll just switch off the flame and let it cook in its own steam for about some 10 minutes, and then we'll serve it in a serving bowl. After 10 minutes, you can see the rice is cooked in its own steam and it is really cooked very well. So now we'll just put this into our serving bowl. Our Shahi Jeera rice is ready.